Hello everyone, welcome to episode 6 of turning one Ethereum into a CryptoPunk. So like always in this video, I want to update you on our journey, share with you some of the recent trades that I've made, my rationale behind them, and at the end of the video, I want to share with you how my thoughts of owning a CryptoPunk have changed in the past week and a half. Okay, so let's get straight into it. So here is our Excel tracker, which is linked in the description. So the beginning balance, what we started with, the current balance in the MetaMask, the total amount spent on gas fees, and the lowest CryptoPunk, which is now 123 Ethereum. When we started this journey, this number was around 20. So, the floor is our enemy. Okay, so last time we left off at this Tulipa trade, but I just want to walk through a major sale that we had actually last night, which was this art block sale, the Ecumenopolis, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. So this was an art blocks piece that I purchased about a month ago now, and it sold last night for 24 Ethereum, which was great news because I was really running low on funds. But other than that, a lot of this other stuff has still not sold, so I'm waiting on it. But let's get started with some of the newer trades. So the first trade that I made was buying two of these party penguins for 0.98 Ethereum. And the reason for this trade was really based off of momentum from Pudgy Penguins, which is another penguin project that just totally exploded over the past month. So my hope was some of that momentum would roll over, especially because some big names like Pranksy, they actually bought a lot of these penguins. So I thought there might be some momentum shift, but I think eventually these might sell. The next trade was Crypto Strikers, which is a 2018 football project. So basically you can buy football or soccer players. And I actually purchased two of them. I sold one of them, but I have bought this other one, which has yet to sell. So that is why you can see in this column that it is in blue. Although currently we're at a loss, one of them still has not sold. So I'm waiting on that to sell. Okay, the next one is another sports project, which in hindsight, I have to stop myself from buying a lot of these projects because I really don't know much about sports. So, but this one, a player token, was another old project where you could buy these NFTs of baseball players. So I purchased this one for very cheap and I have it listed, and hopefully this will sell as well. This next project, Crazy Crow. Now, this I think was a bit of a mistake because I found out about this project on Twitter and I saw that they had a partnership with chess.com, which seemed unique to me. And so I purchased or minted five of these crows, and the total cost was 0.15. But now the floor price is like less than 0.01. And I think these ones are probably worthless as I've written. So if they don't sell within the next week, then I'll just incur that loss. This next project, Crypto Tarot, is yet another 2018-2019 project, and they claim to be the first tarot cards on blockchain. So I purchased two of these cards, and they were quite cheap as well, and I've received offers that are, 5, 10 times their price, but I think I will hold on to these because the supply is limited to 100 only, and, if this gets on, then I think this can do well. So I'm just going to hold on to them. So this next project, Zanzibar's Kids, is actually a photography project by an artist who I discovered on Twitter. And I think generally it's important to have a bit of photography in your portfolio because recently it has gained a lot of momentum. And I read somewhere that the four places that you want to be in, number one, you want to be in some kind of a PFP project. Number two, some kind of generative arts like art blocks. Number three, in photography. And number four, in one-of-one art. So this fulfilled one of the criteria. And I love this project and the story behind it. So basically, the artist went to this island off the coast of East Africa and captured photos. And the artist is also going to send donations in the form of cameras to these children. And I think this has the capacity to catch on. But for something like this, I mean, it's hard to trade And I didn't really buy it for the intention of, selling it really quickly, because these are things that have good stories behind them and they have a lot of potential. So in my eyes, it's worth to hold on to them. So this next investment is another Rare Paper investment. And as I've mentioned in the previous video, I think Rare Papers are really gaining lots of momentum, and they really are, in some sense, where things are headed, because they are really 2016 projects that have immense cultural influence. So I think they will gain lots of attraction, and it's still quite early to invest in them. So here I invested in another card. So if you remember previously, I also have a Pepe Ross card, and in addition to that, I just bought this Wagner card. So this is how it looks. And thank you to Daniel Got Hits, who is a Twitter account that you should definitely follow. He actually posted about this card, and I read up on it really quickly and was able to get it for 2 Ethereum. But basically, the Honus Wagner card is the most expensive card that has ever sold. So just because of that, there was this meme here. So this can have long-term value. One of these sold for about 13 Ethereum today, but I don't want to take quick profits here. I want to really get its true value. So I'm holding on to this one. And of course, the Pepe Ross, which I bought now about 3 or 4 weeks ago, I'm also holding on to. So this next project is created by an amazing artist, Pinder van Erman. And this project basically uses a combination of robots, computer science to create these BitGans. And this project, you basically had to put yourself on a reserve list. And fortunately, I was selected. So I was able to get this for 0.1 Ethereum. There are already offers on it. But once again, this is another sort of longer term hold. So this last project I actually purchased today. This is an ArtBlocks factory project by Mitchell Chan called Luit Generators. If you don't know, Mitchell is an OG crypto artist. His work, Digital Zones, actually sold for 200 or 250 Ethereum today. And he's one of those sort of undiscovered artists that people are now just realizing. And this is his ArtBlocks project that I was able to buy two of today. And this is how it looks. So I'm hoping this will go up in value. Definitely, it has a lot of momentum behind it. One of those Digital Zones that I mentioned is going up for auction this upcoming week, and I think the momentum will roll over to this project. And I actually mentioned about that Digital Zones project in the Discord group. So if you haven't joined, please do. I actually mentioned if people wanted to mint it, they could. And yeah, now they're going for just crazy numbers. So those are really the trades that I've made. And as you can see, a lot of the projects I haven't sold. And that's kind of on purpose, because I have made a lot of mistakes where I've sold projects too early, notably Etherrocks, which I don't want to talk about. But I think there is value in holding on to things long term, definitely. So a lot of these things I'm holding on to, and also just trying to see trades here and there. So now I also want to mention a little bit on how my thoughts of owning a CryptoPunk have changed over the past week and a half. So of course, this journey is all about getting the CryptoPunk, and that's still the primary goal. But before, when I used to see these CryptoPunk floor increases, I used to sort of feel bad, like, oh, and now I have to work harder, this and that. But now I realize that the fact that I have this liquidity and capital, it allows me to trade up to that. And if I have it all locked up, let's say in a CryptoPunk, that means I really have nothing else to work with. So from a liquidity perspective, I can definitely use this to trade and get into other projects as opposed to having it all locked up. But of course, once I'm able to get that CryptoPunk itself can be traded. And a lot of people actually do that, where they buy in at low prices and then they sell based off of different catalysts. So hopefully you enjoyed that episode. I have a whole lineup of new videos coming, so please subscribe, like, join the Discord, the Twitter, everything, if you haven't. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.